Dan Rosen here in our 30 and 30 series continues today with the Montreal Canadiens. They were first in the Atlantic Division last season with 110 points, but they lost in the second round of the playoffs in six games to the Tampa Bay Lightning. The summer started out well for Montreal. They were able to re-sign defenseman Jeff Petrie to a six-year, $33 million contract. That's a good signing for Montreal because they're a team that needs to control the puck more, and Petrie is a guy that will help them do that. They signed Alexander Semin to a one-year contract. Even coach Michel Therrien said Semin's going to be a challenge to coach, and he will be, but Semin has played well on one-year contracts in the past with the Carolina Hurricanes most recently and with the Washington Capitals. But when he signed a five-year deal with Carolina, he wasn't as good, particularly last season when he had only 19 points in 57 games, and the final 3 years of that contract were bought out. Brandon Prust is out, traded for Zach Cassian. Now, Cassian's a big guy, 6'3", 214 pounds. He can probably score more goals than Prust, and he's going to have to do that, but he won't endear himself to Montreal fans if he spends a lot of time in the penalty box. 81 penalty minutes in 42 games last year with Vancouver, 124 penalty minutes in 73 games the year before that. The big question for Montreal, it goes back to what I was talking about with Petrie, and really it has to do with Carey Price. Are the Montreal Canadiens going to be able to help out their goalie, help out Carey Price, more than they did last season? Now, Price was the MVP of the league, Vezina Trophy, historical season, but Montreal was 21st in the league in shots against per game at 30.1, and they were 23rd in the league in shot attempts per game, the differential there at minus 219. That's not good enough. They can't count on Carey Price backing them up the way he did last year. He's an elite goalie. We know that. Maybe the best goalie in the NHL. But is he going to have another historical season? It's hard to say that he will. So Montreal needs to be able to control the puck better. And that's going to be the difference, I think, for the Canadiens. If they're able to do that, they're a Stanley Cup contender. If they're not able to do it, they're still a playoff team, but they might not be at that elite level.